The default ArchiCAD library contains over 1,000 parametric elements, which makes modeling extremely productive. We can also search for additional objects in the BIM Components portal. Notice that the content of the ArchiCAD library may be different in the various local versions of ArchiCAD. Now we're going to add some sanitary equipment. Double-click on the Object tool in the toolbox to open the Object Default Settings dialog. Locate the Plumbing Fixtures folder in the Basic Library, Furnishing, Mechanical folder. Select the Multi-Basin Counter object. Enter 80 mm for bottom offset to home story value. Enter 90 degrees for rotation value. Set the anchor point to the center. Click OK. Click on the midpoint of the wall as presented on the screen to place the multi-basin counter. We would like to create a bath stall. The width of the bath stall should be equal to the width of the toilet area. Let's measure this distance. Click on the measure icon in the standard toolbar. Click on the left corner of the toilet area and move the cursor to the right. The tracker will display the required distance, 2,775 millimeters. Open the Object Settings dialog and select the Commercial Bath Stall object. Enter Bath in the search field to locate and select the object. This object can have many variations depending on its settings. It can form urinals, toilets, and several partition types. Enter 80 mm for elevation height, 2,775 mm for dimension 1, 955 mm for dimension 2, and 2,600 mm for height. Enter 0 degrees for rotation. Display the Commercial Bath Stall Settings panel and switch to the Stall Settings Plan page. Uncheck End Division 1 and End Division 2. Modify the number of stalls to 3. Make sure that the interior furniture layer is selected. Enter 925 mm for element width. Set the anchor point to the upper corner of the left division in the Preview and Positioning panel. Click OK. Set the special snap points to divisions 3 in the standard toolbar. Click on the trisect point of the horizontal wall. Create a marquee on the floor plan view and check the results in the 3D window. Let's return to the floor plan and remove the marquee by pressing Escape once. In the last step, we'll furnish the kitchen. Open the Object Settings dialog. Locate the Furniture Layouts folder and select the Kitchen Layout object. Enter 80 mm for bottom offset to home story and 270 degrees for rotation angle. Open the Kitchen Settings panel and display the Layout Dimensions page. Select the Straight Layout. Select Interior, Furniture for Layer. Display the Accessories page. Uncheck the cooktops, ovens, and washers, so only refrigerators, sinks, and dishwashers are checkmarked. Display the Preview and Positioning panel and relocate the anchor point to the bottom left corner of the kitchen layout. Click OK to close the dialog. Place the object on the floor plan. The anchor point will be the left end point of the 600 mm length wall segment on your right. You may notice that the kitchen layout needs some further adjustments. We can rearrange the individual components of the kitchen layout object on the floor plan. Select Refrigerator at its center anchor point. Select the Move Node option from the PET palette. Type Y and -705 in the tracker. Press Enter to reposition the refrigerator. Move the tall cabinet to the bottom corner. Drag its middle node up to the upper edge of the horizontal wall segment. Type Y300- and press Enter. We would like to stretch the kitchen cabinet so that it reaches the refrigerator. Click on the upper left corner of the cabinet and stretch it. In the same manner, stretch the wall cabinet element. We are going to drag the sink into the kitchen cabinet. Finally, drag the dishwasher next to the sink. Let's view the final layout in 3D. Draw a marquee and show the marquee in the 3D view. Save the module file. Open the Office Building 2 project file. When opening the project file, we receive the warning that a module has to be updated. Choose Update to proceed. On the floor plans and in 3D, we can confirm that all the additions to the module file are now present in the project file. You may also use the 3D cutting plane to see the building from different cut views.